Howdy, it's Bergs, and this is the Cali76 limiting amplifier from the guys at Origin Effects. And Origin Effects are run, or mainly designed by a fella called Simon Keats, who's a killer guitar player from the UK. Also runs Keats Audio, designs for a number of other serious hi-fi audio companies, and is a big fan of the old UREI 1176, which I think is now owned by Universal. So he's decided to put one into a box. Well, it's not actually a UREI 1176, but it's a very large tip of the hat to that particular piece of gear. This is a US standard 2001 Telecaster, and it's got Mick Brearley's Burgerman signature pickups in it, which, through the clean channel of a Laney VH100R, sounds like. This. We switch our Cali76 on and. Everything becomes a little bit wider with more dimension and flatter and louder, which is a cool thing. Now, you'll see here we've got a ratio knob which will take you from 4 to 1 up to 20 to 1, which is widely regarded as limiting. So if I turn it on. Our input volume here is basically the front end of the preamp, and a fabulous preamp it is too, and that's why they've called it a limiting amplifier, because there is actually some preamp things going on in here in terms of tone, and it's got a big tone. The input will hit the front of the preamp as hard as you want it to, and of course the harder you hit it, the more compression you're going to get. Now that's at 20 to 1. If I back this off, get it, and you can alter your output volume with the output knob. Great sound. We've got attack controls and release controls. Attack is basically how quickly that slope to the compression threshold is going to be. So you've got a little thing here that says snappy or non-snappy. So if I put it all the way to the right or clockwise. Bring it back. If I bring it back there, we've got a little bit of the original tone. It takes a little bit for the compressor to kick in. But I can go super squish. A lot of compressors will shave off the bottom end and even a little bit of top end, or add too much top end, you know, one or the other quite often. Some of them come with a tone control. This just adds something. In the same way that an old Echoplex preamp used to add something, or even a Klon adds, you know, that little special thing, which is pretty cool. The release control. Am I raving? I think I am raving. I quite like this compressor a lot. The release control is basically how long the compressor will hang on to that threshold before it goes idle. So if I put it all the way back here. If I wind it up. Now that's going to be important for things like drums and bass and vocals, which you can use this for. In fact, there is also a Cali76 transformer version, the TX version, which has high gain, low gain pads and stuff like that in it, for great for bass players or studio use with other types of instruments. But this will do the job as well. Sounds great. Okay, let's have a listen and see what it does with some dirt. And here's my dirt channel from the Laney VH100R. Just makes everything a little bit wider, gives it more dimension. I'm going to back that dirt off a little bit. if I want to hit the front of the amp a little bit harder, all I've got to do is basically up the output here. Inside you'll find special jumper switches which allow you to adjust the input gain and also allow you to tell it whether it's true bypass or buffered bypass. If you're running long cable runs and stuff like that, you might want to use the buffered bypass, which I actually prefer if it's a good buffer, and this one is. This is the Cali76 limiting amplifier. One of the best compressors that I've ever used, maybe the best. I'm not going to say it's the best on the market because I know that there are others out there that I haven't tried yet, but at the moment,